The
occultism was at a very height in Babylon.
The community
which you are living.
Look at occultism
in that corner. Look at secret cult in that corner. And that's what brought the defilement. The defilement of the laws. You come to Babylon. There's idolatry. And Nebuchadnezzar said, small idols. They collected all of them together, all the gold in the land, and he made a gigantic idol. He said,
"Those
will be the headquarters of idolatry." You at your Babylon around you, man. Look at idols. Look at shrines. In daylight, and see what is happening. And Nebuchadnezzar said he will worship. His family will worship, and everybody that comes to this land, they said they declare holiday. They say it's a day for ritual. It's a day for festival. And they say anybody, foreigner or anybody, coming from anywhere, if you don't worship this one,
I'm
going to cast you to the furnace of fire. Look at the first people over there in our community. And you say, "No, I am a church goer."
You
say, "Okay, if you will not worship with us, bring your money. Bring your contribution. You must contribute. If you don't contribute, it's like you bought something from them. And you didn't buy anything from them. And they're knocking at your door. Your money. What kind of money? Idol money. Idol money. Because there's the headquarters of idolatry. And then you come to Babylon. There's blasphemy there. You find blasphemy. Have you seen them? Have you heard them? They're not drinking parlor there. Have you heard their blasphemy? Have you heard how they take the Bible? And they take the songs of the church. And then they'll be singing it over there. They turn it upside down. And then they make the songs of the church a kind of media for idolatry and for adultery and for fornication.
As we
come to Babylon, you find wickedness at its heart. And you find violence at its heart. And that's where we are. That's why we're suffering. But thank God today, we're coming out of this defilement. I said you are coming out of this defilement. The defilement in this land. The defilement in this community. It's affecting everybody. But somebody there will be like a Shadrach tonight. There's an Abednego there tonight. There's a Meshach there tonight. And then you make up your mind. You're taking a decision. Decision. Everybody shout decision. Hear you decision. Mushi people have a voice decision. See, there was immorality. Have you read the book of Daniel before? Here is Belshazzar now. And he collected all the instruments in the house of God. He was not an ordinary drinker. A drinker of beer. He was not satisfied to drink ordinarily from his own cup. He said, take all those things they use in the house of God. That we got out of Judah. The one they used to serve their Passover drink. And then in the days of today, what they used to do for Holy Communion,
they
said, go take all those things. He was a blasphemous drunkard. You know how many concubines here? You know how many wives here? You know how many visitors were invited? Are you okay? And this is the land in which we're living. They will not come to church.
No,
they will go to all these places
places of idol worship. And the system is sucking in the young people.
It's
sucking up all those teenagers. And then you see them boys and girls. And you are there tonight.
That
defilement will lead to destruction. Because that decade, these
Belshazzar,
he was drinking and he was blaspheming the name of the Lord. And the hand of God came from heaven and wrote in a language he didn't understand. And wrote in a writing he didn't understand.
They
came upon him. His knees began to knock together. The day is coming. The day is coming. That the people of this world, they will move out of defilement because they don't pass through the door of decision. They don't go through the door of decision. They're not like you tonight. Because tonight you are a man of decision. Am I talking to somebody there tonight? You're a woman of decision. And
pursue,
even though you have been defiled, even though things have gone wrong, but you come tonight out of defilement and you go through the door of decision, something good is coming your way. Praise the Lord. Congratulations. You will not perish with them. You will not die with them. You will not be judged with them.
Belshazzar,
Belshazzar, he avoided the door of decision and came from heaven and wrote in language you didn't understand. Called all the magicians to interpret. Imagine those who are telling occultic people in what they call church to come and interpret Bible for them. Can you imagine somebody, they say they are in church and they call secret society people on Sunday to come and read Bible to them and interpret the Bible to them?
Let me,
in what they call church, in secret called Sunday, coming to teach Sunday school. That is in occultism. He asks the wise man while he's trying to open the Bible and he's not talking about Jesus, he's interpreting. Can you imagine that? And so Belshazzar called all the people. In their stomach, that woman, a witch, will never do anything like that. I don't know about you.
One obi nika wan koro bika o ma fi oro ra awon obirin ninu oko to ba je temi ni obi nika to jaje ko ni fun ko ra mi ni ku o ma pa je.
So they could not give the right interpretation.
Ni to na won o le so tumo to peye.
Here comes Daniel.
Ni la wari Daniel to
se that triching is from heaven.
O ni o ta ko yi o si orun lo ti wa.
Wait and you have found one.
O ni ati won lori won asiri ke
ogbe. Wait and you have found one.
Ati won ogbe won.
Has turned from defilement to damnation. From defilement to damnation. The door was open. The door of mercy. The door of salvation. The door of forgiveness. The door of decision. He couldn't see the door.
And
not tonight I see the door.
And not
tonight I see the door in front of
you.
The door of decision. You will escape. I said you will escape. Who am I talking about? I said you will escape. You will not die. You will not be destroyed. That damnation will pass over you in Jesus' name. Because when I see the blood, I'm talking about the blood of Jesus. When I see the blood, I'm talking about the blood of the Lamb. When I see the blood, I'm talking about Jesus who went to the cross of Calvary to die for you. When I see the blood, I will pass over you the door of decision. And then as you see that door, are you ready? I said, are you ready? After all that defilement in Babylon,
lẹ́yìn gbogbo ìdíbàjẹ́ Babylon,
how can we escape?
Báwo ni a ṣe lè sá àsálà?
Ìkejì
báyìí,
the decision.
Only ipinu.
The decision.
Ipinu.
There are many kinds of decisions.
Only ru ipinu lo wa.
There are some people that take a decision just for today.
Àwọn èèyàn kan wà tí wọ́n máa ṣe ìpinnu fún òní nìkan.
There are some people that take a decision just for the moment.
Àwọn èèyàn kan máa ṣe ìpinnu fún àkókò tá a wà yìí nìkan.
The land in which we're living.
Njẹ́ ọmọ ilẹ̀ tí à ń gbé yìí?
They don't know the value of decision.
Wọn ò mọ bí ìpinnu ṣe ṣe yébi yẹn tó.
And the generation in which we're living.
Ìran tí a sì ń gbé yìí.
They do not know the value of decision.
Wọn ò mọ bí ìpinnu ṣe ṣe yébi yẹn tó.
See these young people.
Ẹ wo àwọn
ọ̀dọ́mọkọ̀ about a few months there.
Lẹ́yìn ìgbà tí wọ́n bá lọ oṣù bíi mélòó kan bẹ̀.
I see them under the bridge.
Mo wá rí wọn lábẹ́
bíríìjì. I see them on the road.
Mo rí wọn lópòpónà.
And I say, why are you not in school?
Wọ́n ní akínọ́lé tó sí léwe.
Said I decided to change.
A ní mo pinnu láti yí padà ni.
They cannot take a decision and follow it through.
Wọ́n ò lè ṣe pinnu kí wọ́n dúró nú ẹ̀.
Look at that people, they call them couple.
Ẹ wo àwọn èèyàn yẹn wọ́pọ̀ lọ́kọ̀ọ́.
They went to the altar.
Wọ́n lọ sí orí pẹpẹ.
Just about a few months ago.
Fún bí oṣù mélòó kan sẹ́yìn.
And now, since they took the decision to marry one another.
Lẹ́yìn tí wọ́n ṣèpinnu láti fẹ́ ara wọn lọ́kọ̀ọ́láyà.
1 year has not passed.
Ọdún kan ò tíì lọ.
This one is living there, that one is living over there.
Eléyìí ń gbé ibì kan, èkejì tún ń gbé ọ̀gbìn lọ́hùn.
There is a spirit that is scattering them.
Ẹ̀mí kan wà tó ń tún wọn káàkiri.
There is a spirit that will break their decision.
Ẹ̀mí kan wà tó ń já ìpinnu wọn.
This generation of people. People,
ìran àwọn ènìyàn tí à ń gbé yìí.
They don't know about decision.
Wọn ò mọ nǹkan kan pa ìpinnu.
That's why I come to you tonight.
Ìdí yẹn tí mo fi tọ̀ yín wá lálẹ́ òní.
Something will come inside you.
Ohun kan yóò wá sí inú rẹ.
Power will come inside you.
Agbára yóò wá sí inú rẹ.
Number two, the decision of a lifetime.
Ìkejì ni ìpinnu gbogbo ojú ayé ẹni.
The decision of a lifetime.
Ìpinnu gbogbo ojú ayé ẹni.
The decision you take.
Ìpinnu tó ṣe.
And that decision goes up for 1 week.
Tí ìpinnu náà yóò sì tẹ̀síwájú fún ọ̀sẹ̀ fún oṣù kan.
And for 1 year.
Fún ọdún kan.
And the decision is still there.
Ìpinnu náà sì wà ń bẹ̀.
Now you are young.
Báyìí ọ̀dọ́ ni ọ́.
You take that decision.
Ó ṣe ìpinnu náà.
And then you are old.
Ó wá ń gbé òbá dàgbà.
The decision is still there.
Ìpinnu náà sì wà ń bẹ̀.
The decision of a lifetime.
Ìpinnu gbogbo ọjọ́ ayé ẹni.
That's why you'll find.
Ìdí nìyẹn tó fi
ṣàwárí. The people that got miracle.
Pé àwọn èèyàn tí wọ́n gba iṣẹ́ ìyanu.
The people that got transformation.
Àwọn tí wọ́n gba ìsọdọ̀tun.
You find them in the book of Daniel.
Ó rí wọn nù ìwé Dánìẹ́lì.
And they were people that had the decision of a lifetime.
Àwọn ni àwọn èèyàn tí wọ́n ṣe ìpinnu gbogbo ọjọ́ ayé ẹni.
Listen to one of them.
Tẹ́tí sí ọ̀kan lára wọn.
And it's in Daniel chapter 1.
A sì rínu Dánìẹ́lì oríkìní.
And it's in verse 8.
Ó sì wà ní ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹjọ.
And it says, but Daniel purposed in his heart.
Ó sọ pé ṣùgbọ́n Dánìẹ́lì pinnu nù ẹni ọkàn rẹ̀.
But Daniel purposed in his heart.
Ṣùgbọ́n Dánìẹ́lì pinnu nù ẹni ọkàn rẹ̀.
There are some decisions that come out of sentiment.
Àwọn ìpinnu kan wà tó máa ń wáyé nínú oṣù
sáájú. There are some decisions that come out of follow-follow.
Àwọn ìpinnu kan máa ń wáyé nítorí pé
a kàn tẹ̀lé lásán. There is a decision that comes out of a temporary sentiment.
Àwọn ìpinnu kan kàn máa ń wáyé lásán nítorí ní tó ṣẹlẹ̀ lọ́wọ́lọ́wọ́.
But there is a decision that comes from the head.
Ṣùgbọ́n ìpinnu kan wà tó ń wá láti inú ọpọlọ.
They just okay, that's what they said.
Dá náà ṣe bí tí wọ́n sọ ni.
They said stand up.
Wọ́n ní dìde.
I stand up.
Mo sì dìde.
Raise up your hand.
Nàwọ̀ rẹ̀ òkè.
I raise up my
hand.
They say come out.
Wọ́n ní jáde.
I come out.
Mo jáde.
A decision from the head.
Ìpinnu tó wá láti inú ọpọlọ láti inú orí lásán.
But something from inside
your heart. Ṣùgbọ́n tó ń tinú ọkàn rẹ̀ jáde wá.
Very deep rooted in your heart.
Èyí tó kalẹ̀ sínú ọkàn àyà rẹ̀
ókàn àyà rẹ̀. Explanted in your heart.
A sì gbin sínú ọkàn àyà rẹ̀.
It's coming out of the depth of your soul.
Ó ń jẹ́jẹ́ láti inú odò ikùn rẹ̀ wá.
That's a decision.
Eléyìí ìpinnu náà.
It's a decision that mixes with your blood.
Ó ní ìpinnu tó ń dàpọ̀ mọ́ ẹ̀jẹ̀ rẹ̀.
A decision that goes in your veins.
Ìpinnu tó ń kọjá nù
sàn rẹ̀. Top of your to the tip of your toe.
Ìpinnu tó wá láti orí rẹ̀ tó kọjá lọ sí ẹ̀kan ẹsẹ̀ rẹ̀.
A decision in your heart, in your soul, in your mind, in your spirit.
Ìpinnu tó wà nínú ọkàn rẹ̀ nú ẹ̀mí rẹ̀ lọ́hùn.
And you are a bundle of decision.
Ó sì wá jẹ́ tó kún fún
ìpinnu. My whole life.
Gbogbo ayé
mi. My whole self.
Gbogbo ara mi
pátápátá. I come with this decision.
Ó ni mo gbé wá láti ṣe ìpinnu
yìí. The decision of a lifetime.
Ìpinnu gbogbo ọjọ́ ayé ẹni.
Daniel purposed in his heart.
Daniel sì pinnu ní ọkàn rẹ̀.
He said, no matter where I am.
Ó ní ibi kí ìbúrò
The decision I have made.
Ìpinnu tí mo ti ṣe yìí.
The decision that came out of me today.
Ìpinnu tó ti ẹnu mi jáde lónìí. Ní Babilọ́nì.
In Rome.
Ní Rómù.
In Judah.
Ní Júdà.
In Jerusalem.
Ní Jerusalemu.
In Samaria.
Ní Samaria.
This is a decision of a lifetime.
Eléyìí jẹ́ ìpinnu gbogbo ọjọ́ ayé ẹni.
It says today.
Ó ní lónìí.
During the week.
Láàrin ọ̀sẹ̀.
This month.
Lóṣù yìí.
next month. This is a decision of a lifetime. And Daniel purposed in his heart.
Daniel is
and you know the same about Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Decision at the time of trouble. Decision in a time of trauma. Decision in a time of persecution. When Nebuchadnezzar said,
"Is it
true?
Is
it true? Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, that you will not bow down to my idol. And now, if you make up your mind, if you will change, now that you see my face,
and
you see the color of my face, now that you see my fury, if you will change, that
will
be alright. But if not, I will throw you to the fire." Nebuchadnezzar, don't worry yourself.
Nebuchadnezzar,
you made a decision of a lifetime.
Up
on the mountain, the decision is there. Down in the valley, the decision is there. Before the fire of Nebuchadnezzar, the decision is there.
We will
not bend. We will not bow. We will not surrender. We will not submit. These knees will kneel down to the God of heaven. No more idol. No more blasphemy. No more drunkenness. No more defilement. The decision of a lifetime. Daniel had another challenge. He was a man of prayer.
Like
from tonight, you'll be solving your problems with prayer. I said
from
tonight, and the moment you call, God will answer. I said God will answer you. I'm talking to men and women of decision.
Because
you know that heaven is greater than earth, and God is greater than Satan.
That
magicians are nothing in the sight of the ministers of God. And then you have made up your mind. I'm a man of decision. Woman of decision, all your problems will answer yourself by prayer. That sickness will vanish away. That madness will vanish away. That oppression will vanish away. And then they said, nobody must pray. They said, 30 days, 1 month. Nobody will ask anything from God Almighty.
They
said, anything you're going to ask, you will ask from the King. The king does not have salvation. The king does not have redemption. The king does not have the key that opens heaven. And that's what I need. The king does not know about miracle. The king does not have wonders. The king does not know about supernatural. And that's what I'm looking for. And Daniel said, I am a man of decision. All your conspiracy, all your evil, all your plan and plotting, I'm going to trample over everything. You will walk on the devil. You will walk on those demons. All their oppression, all their plots will walk over them. Because you are a man of decision. Do I have any man of decision there? I said, do I have any woman of decision there? And then you look at them face to face. I've made up my mind. They decide they are going to open up a den of lions. All the lions in your life, they are crushed tonight. And then he went to pray. That's what I love about a man of decision. They said,